Hello everyone, this is Gunjan and let us continue our revision session. Previously we had discussed the fourth chapter about heat. Today we'll be discussing on the fifth chapter, that is acids, bases and salts. We'll see what are they and we will see how we can distinguish between acids and bases. So friends, you might have tasted various types of food. So there are certain types of foods which are mentioned in this table. So let us take example. What is the taste of a lemon juice? What is the taste of an orange juice? Well, you will see that the taste is a bit sour in nature. Right? थोड़ा खाटू लगे अपन ने. Orange juice, lemon juice अपन ने थोड़ा खाटू लगे. What about vinegar and curd? They also have a bit sourish nature in their taste. Vinegar is nothing but a type of acid. In case you are wondering or you have never used vinegar, the ready-made pickles which are available in market have lots of vinegar in them. We have next item is tamarind, imli. We all love imli. So it is a bit sweetish, plus it is a bit sour in taste. Sugar, we know it's very sweet. Common salt, namak. Kyun lage? Kharu lage. Amla, amla is again very sour. Baking soda. What is baking soda? So sometimes you know, like there is a rainy season and it's a pleasantful atmosphere. So we would call our mother ke mummy aaje bhajiya kari dena, aaje maine batata vada kari dena, aaje methi na gota khava cha. So in all these items, your mother adds some baking soda in it. Okay. So this. If you try to taste the baking soda, apne emne chakhe baking soda, so it would beat bitter in taste. Ekdam karela jetlu kadu na lage, but it would taste a little bit bitter. It would be a bit salty. So I can say it would be a mixture of bitter and salty. We all know grapes, mangoes taste a bit sweet plus sour. Cucumber has again a neutral taste. So why are we talking about taste in the chapter of acids and bases? Well, the reason is the substances that you find sour in taste are nothing but acids in them. So you may call that the lemon juice, the orange juice, vinegar, curd, tamarind, amla, grapes all have certain types of acids. Now all of these substances do not have the same form of acid, but they have different form of acid, and we will find that in a moment. But the substance like baking soda, which is not sour in taste, it is a bit bitterish in taste. So they are bitter because they have basic nature in them. So you can say that they are nothing but kind of bases. So bases have a bitterish taste, but acids have a sourish taste. Now, is there any other other way I can differentiate between acids and bases? Yes. So we use soap for our bathing purpose every day, right? So if you try to put the soap in a water and create a soap solution, when you try to touch the water, it is a bit sticky. Now, what is soap? Soap is nothing but a kind of base, a washing soda or washing detergent are nothing but types of bases. So if you have a solution of base and if you try to touch that solution, it feels a bit soapy in nature. So you can say that bases will always be soapy in nature, but it does not happen for acids. So try to touch vinegar or try to touch a lemon juice. Would you find anything soapy in it? No, usme kuch soapy nahi hota. So we can say that acids are not soapy, but bases, yes, they are soapy in nature. Now let us talk a bit more about these acids and bases. So in this table here, they have given us a lots of substances and where they are found. So let's see. The substance called vinegar that we were talking about has an acid called acetic acid in it. Ant's sting. What is ant's sting? लाल कीड़ी होय ना ए अपने चटको भरी जाए राइट तो एनो जे स्टिंग एनो जे डंक होय एनी अंदर शु होय सो इट हैज फॉर्मिक एसिड देयर आर साइट्रस फ्रूट्स लाइक ऑरेंजेस लेमन्स व्हाट डू हैव इट व्हाट डू दे हैव एन एसिड कॉल्ड साइट्रिक एसिड वी हैव कर्ड, दही जो आप खाइए, दे हैव लैक्टिक एसिड. स्पिनच, स्पिनच डू दे हैव ऑक्सैलिक एसिड. फ्रूट्स लाइक आमला एंड अदर साइट्रस फ्रूट ऑल्सो हैव अनदर एसिड कॉल्ड एस्कॉर्बिक एसिड और विटामिन सी. गाइस इफ यू आर वंडरिंग व्हाट इज स्पिनच, स्पिनच इज नथिंग बट पालक. अपने पालक की भाजी खाइए ना, सो दैट भाजी हैज ऑक्सैलिक एसिड विद इन इट. अदर फ्रूट्स लाइक टैमरिंड, ग्रेप्स, अनराइप मैंगोज, दे हैव अनदर एसिड कॉल्ड टार्ट्रिक एसिड. सो यू कैन सी दैट ऑल दिस इंग्रीडियंट्स दे टेस्ट बिट सॉर इन नेचर. Why? Because all these ingredients have acids within them. What about other substances like bases? So like calcium hydroxide. What is calcium hydroxide? आपने जो घर में चूनो लगाये ना, ये चूना नो पानी, that is called calcium hydroxide. It is called lime water. Guys, lime water is not the lime water that we get on a soda shop, है ना? आपने soda shop पर lime soda मंगाया है, so that is not made up of चूना. Okay, that is something different. That is a flavor called lime. But this lime water is called chuna. जब आपने चूनो घर पर चूनो लगाए, that is lime water. It is basic in nature and it is chemically called calcium hydroxide. Another thing that you might have noticed is window cleaner. आपने घर नो कांच साफ करो दिवाली पर, तो आपने एक spray ले आए, right? We spray that drops of cleaner on our window, which helps to clean the window very properly. एकदम चौकी थी जाए. So what is it made up of? It is made up of ammonium hydroxide, which is again a base. The soap, as I said, आपने जो रोज नहावा माटे जो soap use करिए, that is nothing but sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide. We have milk of magnesia, that is called magnesium hydroxide. And you might not know this milk of magnesia and the ant sting connection. They are connected with each other. We'll later find out in this chapter, okay? But just to let you guys know what are certain acids and what are certain bases, we had this discussion. So now you might be wondering, okay, how can I distinguish between acids and base? So you can say, oh it's very easy. If I take a taste of an element, agar eno taste khato hoy, I can say that is acid. Agar eno taste bitter hoy, thodo kadwo lagto hoy, athwa thodo mitho lagto hoy, kharo lagto hoy, so I can say that is a base. Agreed. I completely agree with you. But what happens is, suppose you have a solution of window cleaner. आपने जो साफ करिए छे बारी, एनु solution छे. Can we taste it? It is very dangerous for us. आपने नो taste ना करी शक्या. So you can say, okay, there is another option. Like we can touch the solution of bees, and we can say that I if it feels soapy in nature, I can say that is bees. And if it does not feel soapy, I can say it is acidic in nature. Again agreed. But what happens is, in chemistry there are certain chemicals which are highly burning. So if you try to have a acid which is very concentrated in nature, like concentrated hydrochloric acid or concentrated sulfuric acid, what will happen is, if you try to place your finger, it will get burned. That is so much concentrated that you cannot place a finger or any even some metals inside these acids, because they are highly reactive. So it is not possible for us to manually check the solution. Like apne har ek solution ne taste na kari sakya, har ek solution ma apne apni fingers dip na kari sakya. Because of this, we have these terms called indicators. So what do these chemists do? जब भी केमिस्ट्री ना साइंटिस्ट हो, ये लोग कुछ करियो, they created an ingredient called indicators. So what does this indicator do? So indicators are basically some substance or chemical solutions that if you add a acid, it has a different color. If you add base, it has a different color. So this makes complete sense, right? So in order to distinguish between an acid and a base, we use certain types of indicators. So let us see what are these indicators. So we have certain indicators which are available to us naturally. We do not have to make a solution in a laboratory for creating such indicators. So we'll be discussing the natural indicators first. So litmus is one such indicator. And where is it available? So there is a plant called lichen, and as a part of the plant lichen, if we create water to it and if we create a solution, we are able to create litmus out of it, and it is available in market in two colors. It can be either a blue litmus paper or it can be either a red litmus paper. So what happens is, suppose I have an acid and I have a base. If I place a drop of acid solution on a red litmus paper, agar main acid solution ka ek drop red litmus paper pe dalta hu, to kuch nahi hoga. Okay? So I can say that red litmus paper does not get changed if I add acid to it. But on the same red litmus paper, if I place a drop of basic solution, it will turn to blue. Jo red litmus paper hai, wo blue mein turn ho jayega if I place a drop of base solution. So that is about the red litmus paper. Now let's talk about the blue litmus paper. So if I have a blue litmus paper strip and if I place a drop of acid on it, what will happen? The blue litmus paper will turn into red color. I'll do the same thing for a base solution. Main base solution ka ek drop leke blue litmus paper ke upar dal deta hu. Nothing will happen. So I know that there are two litmus papers, red and blue. If a solution is able to turn any litmus paper into red color, then that solution is called acidic. Aisa main bol sakta hu. Agar mere paas ek litmus paper hai, wo koi sa bhi litmus paper le lo, रेड ले लो या ब्लू ले लो, अगर मैंने उसके ऊपर एक सॉल्यूशन रख दिया और अगर उसकी वजह से मेरा लास्ट वाला लिटमस पेपर रेड कलर में टर्न हो गया, आई कैन से दैट इज एन एसिडिक सॉल्यूशन। एग्जांपल, से फॉर एग्जांपल आई हैव अ सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड और आई हैव हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड, उसको मैं अगर रेड लिटमस के ऊपर डालता हूँ तो रेड लिटमस पेपर पहले क्या था, रेड, ड्रॉप डालने के बाद क्या हुआ, फिर से रेड ही रहा। So I can say that since the next part of the litmus paper got turned into red, which is it was already present a red, but phir bhi I can say that drop dalne ke baad kaun sa color turn ho gaya, red. So I can say that those solutions would be acidic in nature. But if a red litmus paper, suppose it was a blue litmus paper, aur blue litmus paper ke upar maine hydrochloric acid dala ya sulfuric acid dala, to pehle kaun sa color tha, blue, uske baad kya ho gaya, red. मैं क्या देखूंगा, बाद में कौन सा कलर हुआ, बाद में रेड कलर हुआ। सो आई कैन से दैट द सॉल्यूशन आई एडेड वाज एसिडिक इन नेचर। ओके, सेम गोज फॉर द बेसेस। अगर कोई सॉल्यूशन ऐड करने के बाद जो लास्ट वाला कलर है दैट इज ब्लू, देन आई कैन से दैट द नेचर ऑफ दैट सॉल्यूशन वाज बेसिक इन नेचर। एग्जांपल, से फॉर एग्जांपल वी हैव अ सॉफ्ट सॉल्यूशन, जो घर में साबुन रहता है ना उसका सॉल्यूशन है। If you place a drop of soft solution on a blue litmus paper, what will happen is no change will happen. The litmus paper will still be in blue color. So I can say that drop dalne ke baad mera color kaun sa raha? Blue. Blue raha, then it is a basic solution. I repeat the same thing for a red litmus paper. A red litmus paper par maine ek base solution ka drop dal diya. रेड किस में कन्वर्ट हो गया, अगेन इट गेट्स कन्वर्टेड इनटू ब्लू। सो मैं पहले का पार्ट नहीं देखूंगा, ड्रॉप डालने के बाद मेरा कलर कौन सा हुआ, ब्लू। सो आई कैन से दैट द सॉल्यूशन वाज बेसिक इन नेचर। आई होप दिस इज क्लियर अबाउट द इंडिकेटर विथ लिटमस टेस्ट। नाउ लेट अस सी, डू वी हैव अनदर सच नेचुरल इंडिकेटर्स? यस वी हैव। दिस अनदर नेचुरल इंडिकेटर इज कॉल्ड टर्मरिक। हल्दी, जो अपने रोज हल्दर यूज करें ना घर में, दैट इज नथिंग बट एन इंडिकेटर। लेट्स सी हाउ व्हाट वी कैन डू विथ इट। सो व्हाट यू कैन डू इज टेक सम अमाउंट ऑफ टर्मरिक और हल्दी एंड प्लेस सम अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर इनटू इट। सो वी हैव अ सॉल्यूशन ऑफ टर्मरिक। व्हाट इज द कलर ऑफ टर्मरिक? हल्दर नो कलर क्या हो, इट इज येलोइश, राइट? सो व्हेन वी क्रिएट अ सॉल्यूशन ऑफ टर्मरिक इट विल बी येलोइश इन कलर। Now, if you try to add acid into it, there will be no change in the color. मैंने मेरे हल्दी के सॉल्यूशन में मैंने सपोज हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड डाल दिया, there will be no change in color. So I can say that turmeric, which is a natural indicator, does not change its color if I add acid to it. But यही हल्दी के सॉल्यूशन में सपोज I added base into it. Base मतलब कि a solution of soap water. मैंने जो सॉप है उसका वो पानी बनाया एंड आई एडेड दैट टू माय टर्मरिक सॉल्यूशन। सो यू विल नोटिस दैट देयर इज अ चेंज फ्रॉम येलो कलर टू रेड कलर। सो आई कैन से दैट टर्मरिक एक्ट्स एज एन इंडिकेटर, एंड इफ द टर्मरिक सॉल्यूशन दैट इज द येलो सॉल्यूशन गेट्स चेंज. सो क्या होगा, वो हल्दी वाले पानी में इफ यू ऐड द सॉप वाटर, द येलोइश कलर ऑफ द टर्मरिक सॉल्यूशन टर्न्स इनटू रेड. सो वी कैन से दैट द टर्मरिक रिएक्ट्स विद अ बेस एंड फॉर्म्स अ रेडिश कलर. सो अगेन इट्स एन इंडिकेटर. नाउ दैट्स अ पॉइंट ऑफ इंडिकेटर. इंडिकेटर डज नॉट मीन दैट इट विल चेंज द कलर फॉर एवरी एसिड एंड एवरी बेस. देर आर इंडिकेटर्स विच कैन चेंज कलर ईदर ऑन एसिड्स और ऑन बेस, बट नॉट ऑन बोथ. But there are also certain indicators which changes their color on both. If you add acid, it will have a color A. If you add base, it will have another color B. So let's take example of one such indicator. It is called a China rose. China rose is nothing but a common flower that is that we all know. So what? How does this this we work as an indicator? So if you see in this activity, we have taken three test tubes. Okay, so in this test tube we have the solution of China rose. So what we have done is, ये जो China rose है, उसको हमने पानी में थोड़ी देर भिगो के रखा है. So after some time, it will create a different color of solution. As you can see here, it is a bit light pink in nature. So the indicator color is light pink in nature. Now, if you add few drops of acids into it, the color changes from pink to an orange color, as you can see. So here, I have added a acid into the indicator, and quickly it changes its color from pink to orange. What will happen if I add a base to it? So we have another test tube where we have added a base to the indicator. So you can see that this color gets changed to a bit greenish color. So we can say that China rose is one of those indicators in which if you add acid, it turns into orange. If you try to add base, it will get turned into greenish color. So now these are some of the natural indicators which are available around us. There are also certain indicators which are made chemically into a laboratory. One such indicator is called phenolphthalein. So phenolphthalein is widely used in our laboratory for the testing purpose of acids or base. So agar laboratory mein aapke paas ye naturally available ingredients nahi hai, so that's why we have a chemical called phenolphthalein. So if you try to add acid, it will have a different color. If you try to add base, it will have a different color. Let us find out. So what happens is, phenolphthalein itself is colorless. फिनोप्थेलिन का कोई कलर नहीं होता, वो कलर है. जैसे पानी रहता है वैसे ही फिनोप्थेलिन भी रहता है. इट इज कलरलेस. अगेन एसिड्स का भी कोई कलर नहीं रहता. सो इफ यू ट्राई टू ऐड एन एसिड टू फिनोप्थेलिन, देयर विल बी नो कलर. प्रीवियसली कलर क्या था, देयर वाज नो कलर. इफ यू ट्राई टू ऐड एन एसिड अगेन, देयर विल बी नो कलर. बट इफ यू ट्राई टू ऐड अ बेस, द कलर ऑफ फिनोप्थेलिन चेंजेस टू पिंकिश कलर, एज सीन इन दिस पिक्चर. यहां पे मैंने आई एडेड a base to my phenolphthalein solution, so you can see that it got changed to pink color. But on the left side, if I try to add acid, as you can see, there is no change in the color. So we can say that phenolphthalein is an indicator which changes its color if I add base to it. Okay. Now using this fact, we continue our solution. What will I do is, I have a phenolphthalein solution. I'll place some amount of बेसिक सोल्यूशन, से फॉर एग्जाम्पल सोप सोल्यूशन और सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. मेरे पास एक टेस्ट ट्यूब है, उसके अंदर मैंने फिनोल्फ्थेलिन डाला हुआ है. उसके बाद आई एड टू ड्रॉप्स ऑफ सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. मैं सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड सोल्यूशन का थोड़े ड्रॉप्स डाल लेता हूँ. नाउ गाइस, सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड इज अ बेस. सो सिंस आई एड बेस, माई फिनोल्फ्थेलिन चेंजेस इट्स कलर फ्रॉम कलरलेस टू पिंक कलर. जैसे कि मेरे टेस्ट ट्यूब में यहाँ पे दिखाया है, मेरा फिनोप्थेलिन सॉल्यूशन का कलर हो जाएगा पिंकिश कलर. बट आई डू नॉट स्टॉप हियर. व्हाट आई डू आफ्टर दिस इज, आफ्टर दिस पिंक कलर, आई अगेन ट्राई टू ऐड एसिड इनटू इट. पहले मैंने क्या ऐड किया था, फर्स्टली आई हैड एडेड बेस. अब मैंने क्या ऐड किया है, आई एम एडिंग एसिड. सो यू विल क्विकली ऑब्जर्व दैट स्लोली एंड ग्रेजुअली द पिंकिश कलर ऑफ दिस सॉल्यूशन गोज अवे. जो मेरा फिनोल्फ्थेलिन का कलर पिंकिश हो गया था बिकॉज आई हैड एडेड अ बेस, दैट कलर पिंकिश कलर विल स्लोली गो अवे इफ आई ट्राई टू कीप ऑन एडिंग एसिड. And जैसे जैसे देर विल बी अ पॉइंट दैट द एंटायर सोल्यूशन विल बी कलरलेस. सो क्या हो गया, फर्स्टली व्हेन आई एडेड अ बेस उसका कलर था पिंक एंड वो कलर पिंक थी गया था. पची जा रहे हो एसिड नापते हो ड्रॉप बाय ड्रॉप, यू विल स्लोली ऑब्जर्व दैट द कलर ऑफ द सोल्यूशन वेंट कलरलेस. ये पिंक कलर में कलरलेस थी गया. व्हाई दिस हैपेंड, दिस हैपेंड बिकॉज ऑफ अ रिएक्शन कॉल्ड न्यूट्रलाइजेशन. सो व्हाट न्यूट्रलाइजेशन इज, न्यूट्रलाइजेशन इज व्हेन यू ट्राई टू एड सर्टेन एसिड इन टू सर्टेन बेस, द बोथ विल कैंसल ईच अदर्स रिएक्शन. दिस प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड न्यूट्रलाइजेशन. बट ड्यूरिंग दिस प्रोसेस समथिंग एल्स ऑल्सो हैपन्स. व्हेनेवर यू एड अ बेस टू एन एसिड, देयर विल बी द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एन इनग्रीडियंट कॉल्ड सॉल्ट. सो ड्यूरिंग माई न्यूट्रलाइजेशन प्रोसेस आई कैन से दैट माई सॉल्ट विल बी फॉर्म. Also with salt, the solution will release some heat because the neutralizing solution is a reaction where an acid is added to a base. So they both will cancel each other's acidic and basic property and the solution will be called a neutral solution. But along with it, it will also release some heat into the environment. So agar aapne jo abhi humne experiment perform kiya, jisme we had phenolphthalein, we added base and then when we added acid to it, यू माइट हैव नोटिस दैट अगर जो टेस्ट ट्यूब को अगर आप टच करोगे, इट विल बी स्लाइटली वार्मर एज कम्पेयर टू द प्रीवियस पार्ट. ऐसा क्यों हुआ, बिकॉज द न्यूट्रलाइजेशन सोल्यूशन रिलीजेस हीट इन टू द एनवायरमेंट. सो अगर मुझे ये चीज को रिएक्शन के फॉर्म में लिखना है, देन आई कैन राइट एसिड प्लस बेस. अगर मैंने एसिड में बेस एड किया, देन आई विल गेट सॉल्ट, आई विल गेट वॉटर. सिंस मेरा सोल्यूशन इज वॉटरी सोल्यूशन, सो आई विल गेट अ सॉल्ट एंड वॉटर प्लस हीट इज इवॉल्व्ड. And one such example is sodium hydroxide, that is a base, and if I add hydrochloric acid, that is HCl, so I am adding acid to a base, then I will get a salt called sodium chloride. Sodium chloride kya hai? Apna namak, apne jo mithu khaye is nothing but sodium chloride. So how is it formed? It is formed by this process. Add hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide, it will form sodium chloride plus water. And again, this reaction will release certain heat energy into the environment. Now there are lots of uses because of neutralization. हम देखते हैं कि neutralization हम अपने everyday life में कैसे use कर सकते हैं. So there might be times where you might have gone for a party और बहुत खा लिया आपने. You have eaten lot manage. आपके हर एक favorite food items थे और आपने इतना तीखा खा लिया, घर आके आपको हो गई acidity. Right, we know that we call it yaar mummy aaje pet ma bahut bada chhe, acidity thai gayi chhe. So what does actually happen, the acid level in the stomach gets risen. So the acid amount in stomach itna badh jata hai ki apne stomach ke andar hame burning sensation hota hai. So what does mom do, mom gives you a milk of magnesia ya fir normal milk. Why, because during the start of our lecture we discussed that milk of magnesia, you might not know it, but it has a basic property. So jab stomach ke andar acid property zyada ho jati hai, we add a base, so it will neutralize the amount of acid in our stomach. So again feel some normal ho jata hai. Yeah, some of you guys will know this tablet called Jalucin. So kya hota hai, Jalucin leke when you take a Jalucin syrup or a Jalucin tablet, so wo jo acid property hota hai usko kam kar deta hai, because the Jalucin will have amount of base in it. Another such example is, if you remember, we had discussed during the start ki jab apni lal kidi apna chatko bhar jaye, so you might observe that there is some allergy formed on our skin. Why? Because the sting of ant has an acid within it. So acid jab apni skin jo react kare, so we get an allergy. Now how do we cancel out this allergy? Well, apne ghar ma if we have baking soda, if you just apply certain baking soda on it, the reaction will go away immediately. So this is another example of neutralization in our daily life. Then there are certain industrial uses of neutralization. Like you might have visited that certain lands in your area will be called a barren land. A land ma kahin vanaspati ugi na sake. So why this happens is because there are no nutrients available in this soil. So either the soil might have gone too acidic or the soil might have gotten too basic. So if the soil is getting too acidic, what does the farmer do? They add certain kind of calcium hydroxide. It is a base. Calcium hydroxide is nothing but some चूना और lime water. So अगर उसका powder आप थोड़ा soil में डाल दोगे तो the nature of soil would again go back to neutral and it will again be fertile. Similarly, there are certain factories, जो factory अपने होते हैं, dehydration होते हैं, they have certain waste products, जो अगर वो ऐसे ही नदी में या नदी के पानी में डाल देंगे, so the water of these factories would be acidic. So what will happen is, when this water goes into a river, there are living creatures who reside into a river or pond or lake. So they cannot live within this acidic water. So what does this factory owners do? Before releasing the waste product, they have to add certain amount of bases within the waste material. So again, the waste material was acidic. When you added some base amount to it, so the solution will be again neutral. So now the neutral water can be released into the nearby lakes or ponds. So that is all about this chapter. Let us see what keywords, important keywords we had discussed in this chapter. These are very few, but again guys, this is a very important chapter. તમે આગળ સ્ટેન્ડર્ડ્સ માં આવશો ત્યારે યુ વિલ લર્ન મોર ઇન ટુ ડિટેલ્સ અબાઉટ ધીસ ચેપ્ટર્સ એસિડ્સ બેઝિસ એન્ડ સોલ્ટ. સો ધ કીવર્ડ્સ આર એસિડ. વી નો વોટ આર એસિડ્સ. વી હેવ સલ્ફ્યુરિક એસિડ, વી હેવ હાઇડ્રોક્લોરિક એસિડ, ઇવન ધ એન્ટ સ્ટિંગ, કાળી કીડીનો સોરી લાલ કીડીનો ડંક ઇઝ અગેન એસિડિક ઇન નેચર. વોટ ઇઝ બેઝિક? વી હેવ સોપ સોલ્યુશન વિચ ઇઝ બેઝિક ઇન નેચર. વોટ ઇઝ ન્યુટ્રલાઇઝેશન? When you add an acid and a base, we get a neutralization, we get a neutral solution. This process is called neutralization. During neutralization, a salt will be formed and heat energy will be released. What is acidic? So, the acids we can say are acidic in nature. Similarly, the bases are said to have basic in nature. A no nature. What is indicator? Indicator is a chemical substance that changes its color if you try to add an acid or a base to it. Jaise blue litmus paper, red litmus paper, some natural indicators were like turmeric, hardar, china rose, and a chemical reaction, chemical called phenolphthalein, again is a man-made indicator. What is salt? So salt is a product that we get during a neutralization reaction. What is neutral? Neutral is the solution is neither acidic nor is it basic. Such solution are called neutral. Now an important point here I would like to mention is, what will happen if you add a neutral solution to acid? मेरे पास एक acid है, hydrochloric acid है, उसमें मैं अगर पानी डालूंगा तो मेरा solution कैसा बन जाएगा? It will still be an acidic solution, but with bit less tendency. मतलब उसकी जो इंटेंसिटी है वो थोड़ी कम हो गई. पहले सपोज आई हैड अ कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड, बहुत ही कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड था, उसमें मैंने पानी मिलाया, देन आई विल स्टिल हैव अ बिट एसिडिक नेचर, बट इट विल नॉट बी एज कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड एज बिफोर. द सेम अप्लाइज फॉर बेसिक. फर्स्ट आई हैड अ वेरी कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड बेसिक सोल्यूशन. इफ आई एड बिट ऑफ वॉटर टू इट, द सोल्यूशन विल स्टिल रिमेन बेसिक, बट द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन विल गेट लेस. So, अगर कोई पूछना है आपको कि मेरे पास पानी है, मेरे पास एसिड है और मेरे पास बेस सॉल्यूशन है, आई डू नॉट नो, मुझे पता नहीं कि किसमें एसिड है, किसमें पानी और किसमें बेस है, बट आई हैव अ सिंगल लिटमस पेपर, उसका कलर है रेड, आई हैव अ रेड लिटमस पेपर. हाउ विल आई नो, मुझे पता कैसे चलेगा कि कौन सा एसिड है, कौन सा बेस है एंड कौन सा पानी है? सो इट्स वेरी इजी. फर्स्ट आई पिक माई रेड लिटमस पेपर एंड ड्रॉप इन टू फर्स्ट बीकर. आई सी अगर उसका कलर चेंज हुआ, अगर उसका कलर चेंज हुआ, मतलब कि इफ द रेड लिटमस पेपर गॉट टर्न्ड इनटू ब्लू, देन आई कैन से ओके दैट इज बेसिक सॉल्यूशन. सो मैं उसको साइड से हटा दूंगा. सो नाउ आई हैव ओनली टू ऑप्शंस लेफ्ट, इधर एसिड और वाटर. नाउ व्हाट आई विल डू इज आई विल अगेन ऐड द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ वाटर इनटू माय एसिड, देन आई विल अगेन चेक द लिटमस पेपर, आई विल टेस्ट व्हाट इज द कलर. Since I know that the red litmus paper will only turn red because on addition of acid, I can say that okay, this was again an acidic solution. अभी मैं क्या करूँगा? एक blue litmus paper लेके आऊँगा. Blue litmus paper को मैं acid के अंदर add करूँगा. अगर if I add acid to blue litmus paper, it will turn red. I know that. सो अगर मेरा लिटमस पेपर रेड टर्न हो गया सो मैं अगेन उस सॉल्यूशन को साइड में रख दूंगा, आई नो दैट इज अ एसिडिक सॉल्यूशन। जो लास्ट वाला सॉल्यूशन बच गया दैट इज